From strange salamanders and toxic newts, to cave dragons and ferocious frogs, here are 17 of the strangest amphibians on the planet. Number 17, Chinese giant salamander. It's recognized as the world's largest amphibian and is native to mountain streams and lakes of China. The creatures can reach lengths of nearly 6 feet or 183 centimeters and weigh in excess of 100 pounds or 45 kilograms. Because it belongs to a family that stretches back 170 million years, it's sometimes referred to as a living fossil. While their skin coloration ranges from dark brown to reddish black, all salamanders secrete a sticky white substance from their skin that is used to repel predators. They're known to make numerous vocalizations, including barking or crying sounds. Some of the noises sound eerily like human children crying, which inspired their Chinese name of infant fish. Number 16, Darwin's frog. If its name sounds familiar, that's because this animal was named for Charles Darwin. The English naturalist discovered it in Chile before it was formally described in 1841. In addition to the forest streams of Chile, they're also found in Argentina. These frogs are notable for their small size and for the triangular shape of their head. That shape, along with their greenish or brown coloration, can make them appear like dead leaves on the ground. The camouflage tactic helps them evade predators until they pass by. Darwin's frog also exhibits some unusual reproductive tactics as well. After females lay eggs, the male swallows them and holds the brood in his vocal sac. The tadpoles develop there for about 6 weeks. After that, the small frogs hop out of dad's mouth to make their way in the world. Number 15, dwarf salamanders. We just mentioned that the Chinese giant salamander is the world's largest amphibian. Now let's go to the opposite extreme and check out one of the smallest amphibians on Earth. The dwarf salamander reaches lengths of only 3.5 inches, 9 centimeters. They're recognized by their long tails and slender bodies and prefer swampy pine woods where they hide under leaves or debris on the forest floor. This species is found in the US from North Carolina to Texas and is sometimes called the dwarf four-toed salamander. Number 14, Argentine horned frog. Found in South America, this animal has an exceptionally large mouth, which it uses to enormous advantage. It's known as a voracious eater, going after any prey from insects, lizards, rodents, and even other frogs. Thanks to its habit of trying to gobble up just about anything that moves, it's sometimes called the Pac-Man frog, or a mouth with legs attached. At a length of 6 inches, 15 centimeters, the frog's mouth accounts for about half its body length. As befits its big mouth, the frog has a big, nasty bite to go along with it. So it's best to keep one's fingers to oneself. Number 13, rough skin newt. This critter has rough, granular skin that contains glands which produce an especially potent neurotoxin called tetrodotoxin, or TTX. It's the same toxin carried by pufferfish and causes death by asphyxiation. Even touching the newt's toxin is enough to cause skin irritations. And it has been documented that eating one of these beasts can kill you. Number 12, hairy frogs. That's a reference to the hair-like structures sprouting on their body. But since the Central African amphibians possess some uncanny similarities to the Marvel Comics character, they're now better known as Wolverine frogs. Like Logan, they have sharp claws that pop out of their skin. The behavior is thought to be a defense mechanism, but it's unknown whether the claws are retractable. And the amphibians' bony claws are not coated with adamantium. But they can still be sharp enough to inflict some serious damage. That's why people in Cameroon will only hunt the frogs while carrying spears or machetes. Number 11, glass frogs. These unusual beasts are native to rainforests of Central and South America. From most angles, they look like your average amphibian, but underneath is a different story. Their stomachs have no pigmentation. Internal organs, including the intestinal tract, heart, and kidneys, can be seen through the skin. The rest of their body exhibits a lime green coloration. Since they live in the trees, that provides them with camouflage among the leaves. It's still unknown exactly why these animals have translucent bellies, or what purpose it might serve. Number 10, common Suriname toad. It's found in South American rainforests and is known as one of the flattest amphibians in the world. It's also considered to be an aquatic creature, living at the bottoms of muddy rivers where it blends in seamlessly. The creatures have no tongues or teeth, and unlike most toads, the males don't croak in order to attract mates. Instead, they make a clicking sound underwater. That initiates a reproductive process wherein the female releases up to 100 eggs into the water. After the male fertilizes them, the eggs are embedded into the female's back, where her skin grows over them until fully enclosed. Pockets are formed which have a honeycomb shape. Tadpoles develop there and eventually emerge as fully formed toads. Once the mother sheds the protective skin, the cycle starts all over again. Number 9. Hellbenders. If nothing else, these giant salamanders get points for having a cool name. The origin of that nickname isn't clear, but some experts think it has to do with the animal's appearance. Maybe it looked like a creature from hell that was bent on returning home. These salamanders from North America can reach sizes of about 30 inches, that's 75 centimeters long, snout to vent, while weighing about 5.5 pounds, or 2.5 kilograms. That makes them the third largest aquatic salamanders in the world. Why do you think they're called hellbenders? Number 8. Black Rain Frog. The sour appearance on its face has earned it the title of world's grumpiest frog. It's native to the coast of South Africa, and despite its 2-inch, 5-centimeter length, it's capable of burrowing tunnels close to 6 inches deep. To deter predators, they can inflate their bodies to appear bigger and more threatening. They can also do this while tunneling to wedge themselves in tightly enough so predators can't extract them. Did you know that when these amphibians mate, the females secrete a sticky substance on their back to help the males stay in place? He will later stay in the burrow to protect the eggs. Number 7. Lungless Salamanders. Although they have some unusual physical traits, herpetologists say that this family of salamanders is the largest such group of amphibians. It's estimated that one species alone has nearly 2 billion individuals that inhabit an area of Mark Twain National Forest in Missouri. One reason for their success is due to their modest size. That enables them to prey on creatures that are too small for many other terrestrial vertebrates. Like their name indicates, these creatures have no lungs. Instead, they respire through their skin and through tissues lining their mouths. Number 6. Turtle Frog. Their name comes from their appearance. This Western Australian amphibian is thought to look like a turtle with its shell removed. They have muscular arms used for digging through the sandy ground, and can grow to around 2 inches long, 5 centimeters. When it's time to reproduce, the male will dig a burrow around 4 feet deep, 1.2 meters, then call out to the female. After a few months of cohabitation, the couple mates and some 50 eggs are laid in the burrow. The young ones remain in the eggs, emerging as fully formed frogs and skipping the tadpole stage altogether. Number 5. Olm. Also called Proteus, the Olm are the only vertebrates known in Europe to dwell exclusively in caves. It's an entirely aquatic species, which is unusual for most amphibians. These creatures eat, breed, and even sleep underwater. They're blind, but they have keenly developed sensory organs. That allows them to navigate the darkness and hunt smaller prey like snails and insects. Although small and slow-moving, the Olm have evolved over millions of years to exist in a subterranean environment. And they lived there for a long time, with lifespans of 100 years or more. Due to their fleshy skin coloration, the Olm are sometimes called human fish, but they might be better known as baby dragons. That name originated in the 17th century, when heavy rainfall in Slovenia washed the creatures up from their caves. Locals thought they were baby dragons that dwelled deep underground. Number 4. Iberian Ribbed Newt. This is the largest species of European newt, and is known for its defensive strategy that involves a good degree of self-mutilation. It's known for having sharp ribs which can puncture through its skin. The amphibian will then simultaneously start secreting poison from glands on its body. Coated with that poison, the ribs can potentially inject the toxins into the mouth of its attacker. The newt's skin heals quickly and without infection, thanks to a superior immune system. Number 3. Sicilians. Despite its appearance, this is not a snake or a massive worm. The creature is an amphibian that belongs to the Sicilian family, but they are often mistaken for the animals previously mentioned. and they can reach some impressive sizes. A previously unknown species was found in Cambodia in 2015, which can grow to nearly 5 feet long, or 1.5 meters. Because they live hidden in the ground, they are considered to be the least known amphibian order. But they are thought to play key roles in the tropical ecosystems of Asia, Africa, and Central and South America. The Latin word Sicilians translates as blind ones, and that's a reference to the creature's eyes, which are small to non-existent. Number 2. Axolotl. While these creatures are sometimes called Mexican walking fish, they are in fact amphibians, and they're not only popular as pets, but are extensively used for research purposes due largely to their regenerative abilities. These critters can effectively regenerate their tail, legs, and even their spinal cord. They're native only to lakes of central Mexico and never develop lungs or take to land. Adults remain aquatic and retain their gills. Unfortunately, these amazing amphibians are critically endangered due to pollution and habitat loss. At one point in 2014, axolotls were thought to have gone extinct in the wild before a few individuals finally appeared. Number 1. All frogs, great and small. The Goliath frog of Central Africa is recognized as the world's largest extant frog. They can measure 13 inches, 32 centimeters from snout to vent, and weigh more than 7 pounds, 3.3 kilograms. So, what's the smallest frog? That would be this creature. It was found by researchers in Papua New Guinea in 2012. It measures only around 1/4 of an inch long, 7 millimeters when fully grown. That's minuscule enough to sit on a US dime with room to spare. The tiny amphibian was found in the rainforest of a tropical island. And it's not only the smallest known frog, it is also currently recognized as the world's smallest vertebrate. Thanks so much for watching. If you enjoyed the video, don't forget to hit that big red subscribe button and click the bell for notifications for our next exciting episode right here on Epic Wildlife.